Difficult to follow that that account of the impact.
Schwer nach dieser Darstellung.
Powerful impact between the machine and the body.
Mächtigen Zusammenstoßes zwischen
I'm going to talk about a much
Körper.
More seductive impact between the machine and the body, but one
which
might also
aber
have
eines, das
shattering consequences.
Auch tatsächlich verheerende Konsequenzen haben kann.
Before I begin, I'd like to
anfange,
just thank everyone at this very inspiring institution.
I could,
in some ways, talk for 30 minutes about the ways in which, if there is a trauma of the technosphere, this institution is somehow the therapy.
But
I will just content myself by thanking everyone
here.
It's always an honor to deal with
the
amazing intellectual and personal hospitality of the House,
intellektuellen und so auch gastfreundschaftlichen Eigenschaften des Hauses, der Kulturen der Welt.
This evening I'd like to offer you four small thought
ich möchte
vignettes.
Heute Abend vier kurze Gedanken
all of which say something about the human nervous system
when
it's brought into contact with the contemporary
technosphere.
I'm going to talk about the technosphere itself as a giant machine, but not just one machine, the totally connected machine of all machines,
vollständig
which
und total vernetzte Maschine aller Maschinen.
Und
ich könnte es auch einfach den globalen
Technomarkt
nennen.
Made up of a vast number of organic
die besteht
and
aus einer riesigen Zahl aus organischen und
inorganischen
Komponenten, die durch zwei Zwillingsnetzwerke miteinander verbunden sind, nämlich technologischer und kommerzieller Natur, die immer weniger voneinander unterscheiden.
In a necessarily incomplete fashion,
in
my four vignettes will try to give a sense of a process that's been in motion for much of the 100 years of now, and that has now reached a certain stage of perfection with the advancement of the internet, which is to say the progressive absorption of individual human energy flows into the vast,
far vaster currents of the universal machine.
And I would suggest that the techno market is powered in this era when data mining is the only real product of several of the world's most valuable companies by energies drawn from deep inside the human organism.
And I'll try to argue that this has the power to dramatically rewire our own libidinal circuitry.
Finally, since we're involved tonight in a trauma investigation, I'll ask if any of this constitutes a trauma. There's no doubt that the takeover of other cosmologies and sensualities by the logic of the machine of all machines
leaves us with a grief
that is sometimes overwhelming. But the human nervous system also has a dazzling flexibility in its ability to fuse with machines, and perhaps there really is no traumatic rupture at all.
So the image you've just seen from the Matrix of
in which
the
machine of all machines is powered by the individual cells, batteries of human bodies, which are stacked up in their millions to supply the energy required, is an image that I want you to keep in your heads.
Bild aus Matrix, und ich hoffe, dass Sie das jetzt auch weiterhin im Kopf behalten während meines Vortrages.
The first vignette, then. Since we're in Berlin, and since we're inaugurating a project called 100 Years of Now, I'd like to begin by describing a childhood memory of a famous Berliner that dates from exactly 100 years ago.
Hier zu erzählen, die
the formidable reputation of Herbert von Karajan, chief conductor of the Berlin Philharmonic from 1955 until shortly before his death in 1989, rests to a great extent on his ability to take a 19th century machine, symphony orchestra,
and to build onto it all the valves and ports
by which it could be integrated into that great machine of machines of which we are all now a part, the global techno market.
Auslässe und maschinellen Ergänzungen.
He achieved this
durch,
first of all by bringing an unprecedented level of
musical
perfection
to the orchestra machine
itself, combining his 100 musicians and performances so lusciously smooth that some listeners felt he had killed the raw energy
that
the orchestras were famous for in the previous era.
So
but Karajan's innovation went far beyond the concert. His tirelessly entrepreneurial management of the orchestra involved him plugging its antique machine into the
great der Konzerthalle selbst. Er hat als Unternehmer das Orchester gemanagt und hat es diese alte Maschine in eine große, neue, expandierende Maschine eingestiftet, nämlich die Aufnahmemaschine, die Teil unserer großen Maschine von heute ist. Und Karajan war ja fanatisch über die Aufnahmen. Er hat diese neuen Aufnahmetechnologien, die Stereo Digital, als erster mitverwendet und hat mehr Aufnahmen als jeder andere Dirigent gemacht. Und er war auch eine Marketingmaschine. Karajan war wahrscheinlich der meist fotografierte Dirigent aller Zeiten und auch ein großer Fürsprecher seines Orchesters. Und er hat es auf Touren in alle Welt mitgenommen und hat eine noch nie dagewesene Zahl an Filmen der Darbietungen Karajan developed new corporate structures and revenue models for his Geschichte orchestra, mündete auch gave in die Geldmaschine. Karajan entwickelte neue Unternehmensstrukturen und auch neue Einnahmequellen für das Orchester, hat Musikern die Option gegeben, auch Anteile an den entsprechenden Einnahmen zu erwerben und hat auch Möglichkeiten gefunden, vormals undenkbare Eintrittsgelder für seinen Auftritt und die des Orchesters zu nehmen. Karajans Karriere ist auch bis in die Zeit von Reagan und Thatcher hineingereicht und in vielerlei Hinsicht ist einer von diesen vielen Pionieren, die dazu beigetragen haben, diese zeitgenössische Weltmaschine aufzubauen, und zwar für die Berliner Philharmoniker, so wie das Alex Ferguson für Manchester United gemacht hat. Beide Organisationen sind fast gleich alt und 1878 gegründet, und er hat das geschafft, durch ein spektakuläres Rearrangieren von finanziellen und Medienenergien und hat also eine lokale Aktivität in den globalen Raum mit lassen können. Wo hat dieser Visionär des Technomarkts nun seine Inspiration von
bezogen? Spät in seinem
hat dann Karajan den Augenblick beschrieben, der seiner eigenen Einschätzung nach entscheidend war für sein Leben als Musiker. Es passierte während eines Spaziergangs am Grundlsee mit seinem Vater und seinem Bruder, als er selbst 6 Jahre alt war. Das geht auf das Jahr 1914 zurück, also 101 Jahre ist das her. Es war Frühling und damit ein paar Monate vor dem Ausbruch des Ersten Weltkrieges. Sie liefen den schneebedeckten Bergen und der junge Herbert und sein Vater kamen und trafen auf eine Gruppe von Karnevalmusikern, Flynn sehr und sie genannt werden, und einer von ihnen spielte die Violine. Sie hielten auf dem Wege an, um den Violinisten zuzuhören, und während die Musik weiter lief, hörten sie auch von der anderen Seite den tiefen Geräusche der sich nähernden Trommeln. Und langsam erschienen verschiedene Gruppen von sogenannten Trommelweibern, also Männer, die als Frauen verkleidet sind und die auf die Trommel schlugen, um den Winter zu vertreiben. Diese sich überlagernden und miteinander widerstreitstehenden Geräusche haben den jungen Karajan begeistert, der dann später davon träumte, solche Energie mit seinem Dirigentenstab auch leiten zu dürfen. Diese Erinnerung muss ein Teil seiner Macht aus der großen Zerstörung gezogen haben, die dann kurz nachher über die Welt hereingebrochen ist. Die Spieler, die Karajan damals gesehen hat, die Musiker, die er damals gesehen hat, waren dann kurz danach schon Arbeiter in einem industriellen Krieg, der alten Kosmologie große Gewalt angetan hat. Um Walter Benjamin zu zitieren, eine Generation, die in einem pferdegezogenen Straßenbahn zur Schule gefahren war, standen unter dem offenen Himmel in einer Landschaft, in der nichts unverändert war als die Wolken. Und unter diesen Wolken, in einem Kraftfeld der zerstörerischen Stürme und Explosionen, stand der kleine, zerbrechliche, menschliche Körper.
By placing this memory at the beginning of his musical life,
Karajan, the machine devotee, asserted his connection to an entirely different universe. One in which the energies of nature and music circulated in ways that the later machine world would make obsolete. But why should a machine builder insist on his own pastoral pre-machinic origins? Bestehen auf seine vormaschinären Ursprünge hinzuweisen. Es scheint paradox, außer dass es diesen Pathos gibt, dass wir diejenigen sind, die wir selbst zerstören, dass es eine grundlegende Struktur der hohen Moderne. Industrielle Kulturen haben immer eine große Romantik darin gesehen und auch spirituelle
We see it in Gauguin, we see it in Mahler, we see it in America, which built such a romance with its native population,
once it had wiped it out. In this way, modernity mines ancient spiritual accumulations, just as industrial societies have mined ancient deposits of carbon fuel. ist die Moderne eine Zeit, die
deep down the machine
tatsächlich die alten spirituellen Sammlungen ausbeutet, wie das die industriellen Gesellschaften mit den Bodenschätzen gemacht haben. Im Inneren hat der Maschinenbauer nicht immer die Überzeugung seines eigenen Optimismus geteilt und er hat sich dann die Welt in eine weitere Maschine verwandelt und seine eigenen Quellen der Inspiration werden dabei
abgetötet
und er muss immer weiter suchen, um weiterleben zu können. Aber seine sinnliche Landschaft, might take die over entirely. Not only the external world, but also his own interiority.
He reassures himself as he goes to sleep by telling fairy tales
that really happened. That once he was a child
and he wandered with nothing around him except vast, unbroken nature,
and his ecstasy was reflected back to him as music. So this is overtaking him. Und intakten Natur um sich herum, die Ekstase, die ihm zurückgespiegelt worden sind in Musik.
Images are a kind of image track, like a soundtrack.
Und ich möchte, dass hier diese Bilder so eine Art Soundtrack in Beatform sind für meinen Vortrag. Und ich möchte, dass ich für den Rest der Präsentation vielleicht auch mal auf die Berge und die Hügel achten, die auf diesen Bildern gezeigt werden.
In some ways, mountains and hills always seem to come back as the compensation for the machine,
eine Art Kompensation, ein Ausgleich für die Technosphäre und für Maschinen darstellen, als ob der Weg aus der Technosphäre heraus immer nach oben führt. Und über die Gründe dafür können wir vielleicht später nachdenken.
Then the second movement.
Nun zum zweiten Satz.
For many other people,
für viele andere Menschen
the prospect of
war
being
die
taken
Aussicht,
over by machines,
von Maschinen übernommen zu werden, sehr viel realer als für Karajan.
Conducting an orchestra
als Dirigent eines
even now one of those
activities
ist man heute
selbst einer Aktivität,
contrary to most other
abilities, the mastery of complex bodily fields such as conducting, but also other things, sports, acting and other musical activities,
is rising in financial value,
precisely because it defies the general logic of the world, the routinization of human function.
These are some of the 100 best paid celebrities in 2015,
all have various kinds of unique bodily function which has great financial value.
But for the majority of people who do not have such unique and
irreproducible skills to offer to the global marketplace,
the possibility that machines might take over their labor
puts them in a much darker and more dangerously intimate relationship to the expanding machine. Und auch gefährliche, intimere Beziehungen mit der
this includes, of course, the once secure professional classes, many of whom have in the last generation moved into the field of computing because they know that for a while they can earn good money writing the software that ensures the redundancy of their class.
But this too will expire, since it is certain that computers will soon be able to write better code than human beings.
Computer code at that point will evolve autonomously, and it will ultimately escape the ability of human beings to understand it. A great number of people in the world today are therefore faced with what we can call in the technical sense proletarianization, and the undercutting by machines of the economic value of their skills is only the first part of it. Equally important is the establishment of a value equivalence between themselves and machines. This, of course, was fundamental to the outrage that erupted in the machine-breaking movements in England and France at the turn of the 19th century. It was not so much that the machine appeared to possess human attributes. No, it was rather that the farmer, craftsman or soldier now possessed no human excess that could differentiate him or her from a machine.
Keine menschlichen Fertigkeiten mehr besaßen,
die
sie von den Maschinen
by the increasing power and intelligence
of machines
is not so much the machines are becoming human.
Macht und Intelligenz der Maschinen beeinflusst ist nicht, dass Maschinen immer menschlicher werden, und auch, sondern dass die Menschen ganz offensichtlich eine Neigung dazu haben, sich selbst zur Maschine reduzieren zu lassen. Wir wissen vom Philosophen Bernhard Stiegler, warum menschliche Wesen ganz besonders verletzlich sind.
Diese Angst seit der Geburt der Menschheit with an inorganic prosthesis,
gab es den biologischen Organismus mit einer unorganischen Prothese,
comes into human life at the same time as the first hammer.
Tritt ins Leben der Menschen ein zur gleichen Zeit wie der erste Hammer. Und für die Art begründet sie eine Abhängigkeit von dem, was er Technik nennt. Die Bedrohung durch Maschinen für die Arbeitskraft ist sehr viel existenzieller, aufgrund der Tatsache, dass Maschinen niemals entfernte externe Wesen waren. Und unser Organismus ist so aufgebaut, dass er mit Maschinen verschmelzen kann, sich um sie herum reorganisiert und sie liebt.
As the contemporary pop psy language goes, no boundaries. It is built to be taken over by machines. And if human beings have sometimes gone out to break machines on a mass industrial scale, they have done so not only because of any potential embedded in the machine, but because of what they have recognized in themselves, their own near infinite receptivity to the seduction of
machines. Für die Verführungskraft der Maschine.
So Hollywood usually breaks out of the machine world
Hollywood with bricht meistens aus der Maschinenwelt aus, indem es Romanzen und Berge zu sehen gibt.
And we're going to see it again in a minute.
Und das werden wir dann in einem Augenblick auch nochmal beobachten dürfen.
And it's the erotic
und das ist
connection of human beings
auch die erotische Verknüpfung der Menschen, die dann gleich später noch zum dominanten Thema meines Vortrags werden. Nun,
the current stage of elaboration of the techno market brings this human receptivity to the machine
into sharp relief with what I shall call techno sex. Ganz deutlich zum Vorschein,
that is to say, the eroticization of the apparatus of the techno market
itself, and the opening up of channels by which human beings will actually have sex with the techno market.
Internet pornography is the most widespread and
conspicuous
channel,
und auch sichtbarste dieser Kanäle.
As I've gestured towards, in Hollywood's presentation of dystopian futures, where the entire world has been taken over by machines.
Immer die Darstellung der gesamten Welt, die von den Maschinen übernommen wurde. Und natürlich sollen wir dadurch einfach glauben, dass in Realität die gesamte Welt noch nicht von Maschinen übernommen worden ist.
One thing remains miraculously unaffected by the general
occupation, total unberührt von der allgemeinen Besatzung, und zwar die erotisch-romantische Anziehungskraft von Menschen füreinander.
Und
das ist also der wirklich wundersame Teil unserer Untersuchung des Technomarktes, dass also die menschliche Identität scheinbar den Regeln des restlichen Universums nicht gehorcht. Aber in unserer echten Welt des Technomarktes ist die menschliche Sexualität genauso wandelbar wie der Rest
human
des Kapitalismus. Menschen, so scheint es, mögen nicht nur Sex miteinander haben, sie können auch lernen, es zu mögen, Sex mit Maschinen
and
zu haben.
Und zu dieser Zeit, Gegenwart,
wenn die Ideologie des Technomarktes in sich in einer vollständigen Krise befindet, ist die Maschine aller Maschinen wie durch Zufall dabei, sich die Unterhose runterzuziehen und fragt uns und bittet uns, wenn wir schon nicht an sie glauben können, dann wenigstens Sex mit ihr zu haben. Weil wir wissen, dass natürlich auch der Kapitalismus von uns nicht möchte, dass wir mit ihm übereinstimmen, sondern ihn hauptsächlich begehren sollen.
Most commentary on Internet-Pornografie concerns the question, does it offer a positive or negative representation of human sex?
And it assumes that its ultimate significance is feedback in the human erotic relationship. But this is to give undue importance to the message when here the medium is all.
Users of Internet-Pornografie are not consuming secondary representations of real sex.
They are not substituting for real sex. Setzen nichts
they are having
echten Sex.
Sex.
Sie haben echten Sex, und zwar mit dem globalen technologischen Apparat.
Internet-Pornografie
ermöglicht es Menschen, sich in die Maschine aller Maschinen einzustöpseln, und zwar auf eine neue Art und Weise. Und das bringt auch eine neue erotische Funktion im menschlichen Organismus.
Every kind of real-world sex
jede Art echten Sexes wird auch im Bereich der Internet-Pornografie dargestellt, und deswegen ist es natürlich für die Benutzer zu glauben, dass dieses Feld nur eine Erweiterung ihres früheren erotischen Systems darstellen.
But the erotic imagery of internet
pornography is only the fantasy interface between the machine and the human.
For the user, the object of desire is not
other humans, but the techno-market itself, precisely because it is of its infinite image-making power. Users are invited to have sex, not with another human being,
nor even with a photograph or a video showing a human
being, but with the universal database in which all these things are housed.
With the database by which the Internet pretends to mimic our fantasy life, thereby restructuring our fantasy life as database. For Internet porn, just like any other shopping site, is organized with drop-down menus, search boxes, and user ratings, and that is precisely the source of its erotic appeal. In the world of sex with machines, technological attributes are erotic attributes. As we see in the reviews of fucking machines sold on Amazon.com, a woman asked the previous purchases of such a machine, is there an Android app so I can control it from my phone? It is clear that such questions are not only practical. The erotic appeal too of the fucking machine rests on its level of integration into the contemporary Internet of Things.
Beruht auf der Ebene der Integration in das zeitgenössische Internet.
What generates the intensity of this new rearrangement of human erotic currents?
Dieses neuen Arrangements von menschlicher erotischer Strömung.
As we know from Marcuse, the seemingly atavistic energies that have arisen within capitalist society since the Second World War to break the stranglehold of what we might call the bourgeois superego, the progressive rebellion against the institutions of the family and the state, for instance, have consistently served to intensify the neural power of capitalism itself. This was, anyway, the explicit ideological project of the neoliberal era. Thatcher and Reagan sought to dismantle all other relationships in favor of one single relationship, the relationship with the market.
Abbauen, und zwar der Beziehung mit dem Markt.
And that relationship has become more and more fundamental in our lives since,
grundlegender in ihrer Bedeutung,
especially as the market
Leben
has merged entirely with
der
computing
Markt
power,
vollständig mit der Rechenkraft
inaugurating a world managed and administered by algorithms. This has perfected the market universe and integrated it fully with our inner world, tapping the human libidinal energy far closer to its source than was previously possible, and simultaneously cutting off users from alternative sensualities, cosmologies, and rhythms of time. It is this primary relationship with the global techno-market and the libidinal energies that course through it, which is expressed through techno-sex. Techno-sex belongs to the era of social media and big data, when the idea that the machine of machines is powered by human life energy becomes entirely literal and explicit and no longer a metaphor. Social media, after all, is a universal mechanism for capturing and circulating human libidinal jokes. They are instantly gratifying because we are able to see the vast machine instantly rearranging itself around every micro-life event we feed it. But the fact that we give something of ourselves away in the process is apparent to us all, which is one of the reasons for the remorse, which is also an inherent part of the social media universe. To universal search engines, we surrendered only our ability to remember. To social media, we surrender our ability to generate our own life force, which is why so many of us are dependent now on the clicks and chirps by which the machine of machines reports back to us on our lives, which we no longer possess for ourselves. It is natural that we be filled with awe at a machine that can steal such stupendous energies for itself and use them to such dramatic effect. Techno-sex is a form of erotic worship of that stupendous storehouse of libidinal energy, the techno-market, that has been inflated to cosmic proportions by our own energies. On the fuel of those energies, it now burns like a vast, bright sun. In the technosphere, techno-sex is ritualized sun worship.
Letztlich eine ritualisierte Form
but this is an obscene god, which is
aber
why techno-sex too is widely accompanied by remorse.
Ganz häufig begleitet
there is no higher purpose
Gefühlen
to Facebook.
Schuld.
It does not represent a vision of nature or
es
mankind,
ist keine Vision
to which we would in normal
Menschheit,
circumstances willingly sacrifice our life's energy.
Energy.
The dark genius of social media is apparent to all of us from the outset, that the energies imminent in our friendships, our love affairs, our collegial debates can all be converted into vast revenues in which we have have no share.
In Facebook is a savage deity, standing for pure monopolistic acquisitiveness,
and it introduces a dreary, nihilistic final stage into what Marcuse called the automation of the superego. The old bourgeois institutions of higher order and conscience, most notably the democratic state, which took the language of lofty ideals and addressed individuals as abstractions without regard to race, sex, religion, wealth, or status, have been replaced by the global techno-market, which in precisely the opposite way addresses individuals in all their unique details and speaks the language of devastating appetites.
In the wake of Deleuze,
we are forced to ask not what desire seeks, but what it produces. Techno-sex produces and continually inflates its own stupendous object of desire, the ever more supreme
Just as with every new friendship, the monopolistic capital of Facebook is expanded,
with every new techno-orgasm, the techno-market expands its absolute hold over our libidinal energy. There is nothing grandiose about this outcome, and we know it well, whereas the dream life of high-minded state systems was made up of surrealism and cruelty. The dream life of the diabolical techno-market is characterized by neurotic order and subjection. Though we have built pleasure zone for ourselves within this lugubrious universe, our pleasure only supplies more power by which the techno-market may diminish us. What does all this mean? And what has it turned us into? Most particularly, given the context of this evening's investigation, does it constitute any kind of trauma? At some very obvious level, human beings do not seem to be traumatized by the new intensity of their contact with machines, quite the reverse. In fact, humans seem to welcome the company that machines provide us, now that they are able to address us at the level of friendship and sex. Through the staggering scale of big data, human beings have now for the first time been confronted with that long-imagined singularity. Computers addressing us with an intelligence that seems rather like our own. We are suddenly aware of what was always known but never experienced, that computer intelligence is developing 10 million times faster than our own, and that we must at some point surrender our position as the most sophisticated beings on this planet. One thing that has emerged with this realization is that human beings have abandoned many of their objections to becoming machines. With machines triumphant, the idea of becoming machines began to seem not abject but grandiose. Hollywood has begun to present the human being become machine not as horror but as lyricism, which is the point of my research notes on the recent movie Inside Out, a Disney animation for children. In this film, the young heroine is controlled by an inner machine, so all these pictures of databases and consoles
are happening.
This is all within the head of the main character. The young heroine is controlled by an inner machine, a combination of a corporate boardroom and a vast computer. But she is not an uncanny or horrifying character, as one would expect from the previous conventions of Hollywood. She is, in fact, the quintessential normal American girl. Her technological engine does not make her less human. It is this, in fact, which manages her chaotic feelings and allows her to integrate humanely with the changing world around her.
Human sich in eine sich wandelnde Welt integrieren.
At a time when so many people have in their working lives become merely the organic prosthesis of a machine brain, working in call centers where they say what a computer tells them to say, or driving a taxi while listening to orders from a computer, the gradual recodification of the human essence as inherently machine brings to this process one thought of as degrading, a more uplifting countermeasure.
In diesem Prozess
The intervention of upstart machines into economic life two centuries ago led human beings to wish to destroy them. Now that machines are so much more dominant, human beings wish to make love to them. And one of the reasons must be because we are now fully prepared to join the world of machines. Perhaps waning humanity, cognizant of machines' triumphant power, makes love to them in order to become them, in order to shore up its own fragility with the steely ascendancy of the winning side. But this is clearly not the only story. The uprooting of human beings over a long period of time from all relations that are not machine relations has clearly led to a whole range of new neurotic tics and nostalgic addictions, which could indeed be evidenced in the trauma. The enormous explosion of discourse about an aestheticization of food, for instance, for food is one of those sensual experiences that cannot be delivered through the screen, and therefore takes on fetishistic importance in the universe I described. In every rich country, chefs and dietitians have suddenly joined the ranks of celebrities. For, like orchestral conductors or tennis players, they represent sensual possibilities of the body which appear even more valuable in the light of the fact that so much of life now happens through glass. Food has become a key arena for human beings to express their anxieties about the techno market and their desire to reconnect to previous sensuality. I believe that the total absorption of human life energy into the technosphere is a collective trauma, one which began to affect us two centuries ago and whose ongoing effects we can discern within ourselves. But I also think that this trauma can never be directly observed, nor even really talked about, which is why it will always fail to be anything more than a speculation. The sociologist Jeffrey Alexander has suggested that even such definitive events as the genocide of the European Jews only became a collective trauma when it was narrated as such. By this measure, our loss of pre-machine relations cannot be in trauma, because it cannot be narrated. Sometimes we hear people saying, for instance, I wish I could have my pre-internet brain back. But in fact, there is no serious way to articulate such thoughts, which are unheimlich. They have no home in our onward rushing time. Even in our own head, such thoughts are foggy and not completely believable. But anyone who tries seriously to assert that the expanding power of machines should be arrested or turned back is assumed to be a ridiculous nostalgic or simply mad. Wirklich anzuhalten because oder zurückzudrehen, wird als lächerlicher Nostalgiker oder als einfach verrückt angesehen, denn diese Gedankenwelt ist eine der Vergangenheit. Wenn unsere Organismen sich immer perfekter in Maschinenwelten einfügen, werden wir immer perverser und paradoxere Ergebnisse in unserem eigenen rebellierenden Nervensystem sehen, Ergebnisse, die die Silhouette unseres Traumas immer deutlicher erscheinen lassen werden. Aber letztlich ist das ein Trauma, das wir nie direkt sehen können. Es hat keine Form, es hat keine Stimme, ganz besonders weil die Sprache, mit der wir sie ausdrücken, of the trauma itself. All we are left with is fantasies of world's past, of medieval sensualities once rampant in the Alps, for instance, the shattering emotional power over us we can never really
explain. Thank you. Vielen herzlichen Dank.